Welcome and thanks for clicking here. In this video, we're going to learn the theme of the place of a woman in the society in the blossoms of the savannah. How are women portrayed in the book? What is the role of women in the Nasilan society? Be sure to stick around because in this lesson, I'm going to give you a detailed explanation on that theme. And remember, it's a major theme in the novel.
One, in the blessings of the savannah, a woman has no say as far as marriage is concerned. It is a man who chooses the girl that he wants to marry. So after a man finds the girl that he wants to marry, he approaches the parents of the girl together with some few elders. And if the two parties agreed, then the girl has no choice. The only choice that she has is to marry that man. You see the case of Mama Milanoi and Ole Kailo. When Ole Kailo spotted Mama Milanoi at a church service, he went to Mama Milanoi's home, and the marriage negotiation was done by the parents of Mama Milanoi and the parents of Ole Kailo.
Mama Milanoi was not involved in that negotiation.
Number two, women are forced to undergo circumcisions. In Nasila, for a girl to be married, she has to be circumcised first. In other words, a girl cannot be married without undergoing circumcision. Ole Sidori's demand that Christian to be circumcised before he could take her as a wife. Tayo is forcefully circumcised in order to marry Ole Sidori after Christian escapes. When Presen escapes to Olaringoi's home, we see that Olaringoi's mother demands that Presen has to be circumcised first before marrying Olaringoi. Most of the female characters in the novel are circumcised. We have Mama Milanoi, who is circumcised before marrying Ole Kailo, and also Ole Supeyo's daughters, all of them were circumcised before they were married off. So circumcision was a must in Nasila.
Number three, women are looked down upon. And we see Ole Kailo appointing Joseph Marmuat to teach the girls how to be responsible women in the society.
This shows how women are diminished such that it is a man who is trusted to teach them the basic cultural values that will help them become responsible wives. In reality, we expect that it's a woman who can play that role better.
A male child is valued more than a girl child. During the time that Resian was born, Ole Kailo was not happy. In fact, Ole Kailo hated Resian from the moment that she was born, simply because he was expecting a baby son who will be the heir of the family, or who will carry the name of the family. For that reason, Resian never enjoyed the love of her father. In Nasila, it's only the boy child who is given the best education. A girl child is not educated. Her role is seen as being a housewife. Ole Supeyo, he had educated all his sons, and two of them were in the university level. But all his daughters were circumcised and married off to prominent elders in Nasila. And some can argue Tayo and Tresian were educated. Yeah, the two girls were educated, but they received their education when they were in Nakuru. And you remember, in Nakuru, culture was not an issue. A woman or women are expected, or they are supposed to be submissive to their husband. They are not expected to question their husband even if they are making the wrong decision. And for example, when Ole Kailo asked Mama Milanoi to start counseling the girls to prepare them for circumcision, Mama Milanoi felt that that was not right for the girls, but she could not question her husband because it is a man who had the final decision, and a woman is supposed to follow the husband's decision, and she is not supposed to go against it. Lastly, the role of a woman is to please their husband, and we see women are trained on how to conduct themselves solely in order to please their husband. They are also trained how to prepare tasty meals for their husband. And during the conversation between Mama Milanoi, Yeyo Botor, and the girls, Mama Milanoi says that when the girls are married and they are accused of laziness by their husband, or their husbands complain that they cannot prepare tasty meals, they are not to blame us. Simply because they have taught them or they have trained them how to conduct themselves as housewives. And that is all about the role of women in the society. Thank you. See you next time. Bye bye.